I accidentally ran a native compiled Emacs, and the speedup was such that I couldn't go back. This compelled me to look at the native comp code closely. The C code was good. The supporting elisp and makefile logic, however, needed a lot of work. Here was the first red flag. Under native compiled Emacs, the load suffixes variable excludes the .eln extension. That .eln files were not first-class citizens means hacks. I understand wanting to sequester .eln files in their own ABI tag directory, but as a first 80% solution, putting the .eln files side by side with the .elc files immensely simplifies the code. I also felt the just-in-time compilation was too slick. Removing that feature and just allowing ahead-of-time compilation, again, simplifies the code and eliminates a bunch of moving parts. Rewriting native comp's makefile sequencing was difficult. At the heart of the complexity is iteratively scaffolding the preload image. Not many users know Emacs installations ship with a platform-dependent, memory-mappable image that pre-populates the Lisp universe. The layering pipeline recalls the Alter Beast arcade game, where a Roman centurion evolves the abilities of a series of successively more powerful creatures. Now, that analogy fails, since every 80s kid knows Wolfman is the best, and Bearman is absolute garbage. But we also know a bear would demolish a tiger in real life, so none of this makes sense. The pre-image, while it greatly shortens startup time, has been a perennial albatross. Its monolith complicates the build sequencing, such that byte-compiled files often get left in an inconsistent state. Rather than puzzle it out, the GNU bros have for years instructed people to invoke make bootstrap when compilation inexplicably fails. Second, the pre-image counterfeits the hack known as load prefer newer. In certain cases, you'll wonder why, despite setting load prefer newer to true, Emacs continues failing to pick up your latest change. Third, the pre-image thwarts a moving garbage collector, since the image reading and writing code assume a fixed layout. There's been a lot of noise on the mailing list about incorporating the Ravenbrook moving collector, but the double copying of the pre-image is unsightly shoehorning. Finally, the pre-image reading and writing code defies comprehension.